Good evening, Dr. Gitlin, Dr. Olszewski, Dr. Yost, faculty members, professional staff, family members, loved ones, and you, our new nursing colleagues. It is truly my honor to be here and have the opportunity to address you this evening. Thank goodness for technology. What an amazing accomplishment, and in a time of a pandemic. You know, you can now add this story years from now. I graduated back in 2021 in a time of a pandemic, and then add your story. But first and foremost, I want to recognize the incredible work of your chairs, your faculty, the pre-licensure department. They have stayed dedicated to your success since your admission to this extremely competitive program. Even in times when you may have questioned them or their reasoning or their exam questions and maybe some of your assignments, but you will hear their voices in your head for years to come. And when you do, be sure to reach out. Their commitment to you has brought you to this moment and will be the silent hand on your shoulder as you begin your professional future. I look back on my remarks to the ACE class of last year and I had to pause. That class finished up their clinical requirements mostly in person, and we were looking at a possible shutdown throughout the country for a few weeks, maybe even a few months. My, has the world changed, and so has the role you will now play in it. You have successfully survived having your classes put online, your clinical experiences canceled, altered, shifted, or completed through simulation virtually. Everything about your program out of necessity had to be altered. Class times, examinations, as I said, clinicals, and classmate support in person. I personally know how important those components of this program are. My son graduated from the ACE program at Drexel in 2017. It was such a pleasure to see all the ACE students sitting together outside of Parkway having lunch, studying, conversing, laughing together in one place without a mask. The endurance to get through the rigor of the program then when it was in person is truly incredible. I remember after every exam and again after boards, he'd walk into my office and complain about how difficult the questions were and how tired he was and how he'd forgotten to eat real food. He does admit, however, that the experience, as frustrating, rewarding, and challenging, was worth every second. He was offered numerous nursing positions right upon graduation because he was a Drexel ACE graduate, tested and true. However, the trials and tribulations that you experienced are far greater. You jumped through every hurdle, every hoop necessary, and here you are. Your experience and your resilience will serve you well. I am an actively practicing nurse for over 31 years. And I've seen many changes in the healthcare system and in our profession, but nothing like this. This pandemic has challenged everything we know, the science and the reasoning behind the why and the how, and quite simply, the what of the future. However, one thing has begun to rise up from all of this uncertainty, this anxiety, this turmoil, and that is the role of the nurse and the nursing profession. Across the nation, we are being recognized for our practice on all social media outlets, television, radio, everywhere. Wonderful expressions of gratitude in all forms, food, discounts, designated protected food shopping times in the beginning of this pandemic, mass bell ringing, hoots and hollers, and lines of professionals with sirens welcoming pre and post shift nurses. And now we are leading the vaccination and testing efforts to help heal our world. As fabulous as this all is, frankly, nurses do what we need to do. It's what we will continue to do, to provide the best comprehensive, empathetic care to our patients and their families and their loved ones all the time and every time, regardless of recognition or healthcare battles. That is and will always be the cornerstone of our profession. No matter what happens, we show up on the front lines and behind. I can tell you that my clinical work, my patients, they are a part of me, every single one of them. I have learned so much personally and professionally from them, and they have touched my life in immeasurable ways. So in thinking about what can I say to you as you begin your new nursing career, I'd be on the screen talking to you for hours, quite frankly. So if I had to pick one most important piece of advice, it would be take the time. You're going to be so busy acclimating to your new role, learning new things, working long and hard hours. Remember that now you are included in the number one most trusted profession in the United States. So that being said, take the time. Take the time to remember the feeling when you assisting to bring a new life into this world. Take the time to remember the impact you have to comfort worried patients and parents. Remember the respect you gain when you have difficult conversations. Remember the comfort you provide to a worried loved one just by answering one question. Take the time to remember the trust you feel by providing the best possible care to your patients. Take the time to remember the gratification you feel when you spend those few extra minutes with a patient who's forgetful. Remember the feeling of being an active voice as a crucial member on patient's healthcare team. Take the time to remember the privilege of holding your patient's hand as they draw their last breath. Remember not only the responsibilities you have as a nurse, but take the time to understand the significant impact you will have on every patient you care for, as well as their family and their loved ones, and the impact they will have on you. So many times you're going to question if you make a difference, particularly now when there's so much loss, yet so much promise. And in those times, I want you to remember this story. And if you've heard it before, I'd like you to listen to it now with the ears and the perspective of a nurse. A young girl was walking along the beach, upon which thousands of starfish had been washed up during a terrible storm. When she came to the starfish, she would pick it up and throw it back into the ocean. People watched her with amusement. She had been doing this for some time when a man approached her and said, "Little girl, why are you doing this? Look at this beach. You can't save all of these starfish. You can't begin to make a difference." The girl seemed crushed, suddenly deflated. But after a few moments, she bent down, picked up another starfish, and hurled it as far as she could into the ocean. Then she looked up at the man and she replied, "Well, I made a difference to that one." The old man looked at the girl inquisitively and thought about what she had just done and said, "I'm inspired." So he joined the little girl, throwing the starfish back into the sea. And soon, others joined as well, and the starfish were saved. You are the future of the nursing profession, and you are a Drexel nurse. You will make a difference. You are already heroes. Congratulations to you and your loved ones, and I look forward to hearing all about your future amazing accomplishments. And we hope to see you soon back for your master's or your doctorate. Thank you. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. I'm happy to be here today to congratulate everyone on this major accomplishment. And I certainly wish we were in person celebrating, but I'm so excited to have this opportunity to welcome all of you into the nursing profession. This past year, you made a commitment to become a nurse during one of our most challenging times in nursing. And in the midst of this pandemic, you attended clinicals and labs and plenty of Zoom classes. You learned to apply research and support your practice with evidence. You learned what it means to be a leader. And above all, you learned about caring for others and the importance of caring for yourself. I've been thinking a lot about what I should say to you. What words of wisdom can I offer? I started searching for the perfect inspirational quote. I looked to writers and poets and leaders and even some sports legends. And then I realized that the wisdom and experience was right here at Drexel. And I went to your faculty. And I asked them to give some parting advice for you to welcome you into the profession. So in no particular order, here are some last words to remember from your faculty. From Professor McLaughlin, keep setting personal and professional goals and never stop learning. From Professor Nitka, the expectation is to be safe, not perfect. Keep learning and move forward. From Dr. Tang, accept any and all opportunities for learning. Nursing is a craft. Dr. Godshall, always ask why and does this make sense? Dr. Barrett, the safest nurse is the nurse who knows what they don't know. Professor Shattuck, know your limitations, it's okay. Dr. Faye Hillier, look deeper, find out what's your patient's story. Dr. Chiatti, channeling Maya Angelou, people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will remember how you made them feel. And from Professor Quay, at the end of the day, ask yourself, what did I do well today? What could I have done better? And how will I be better tomorrow? Now, here are some of my final thoughts. Nursing will test you. It will test your knowledge. It will test your perseverance, and it takes substantial grit and resilience. This past year has certainly highlighted this. Remember, on a day that may be rough for you, it will most certainly be much more difficult for your patient. The nursing profession, my profession, needs you right now. We have much work to still be done as we continue to fight the pandemic, and we also need to address and fight the injustices and healthcare disparities for our patients and communities. Nurses are in a unique position to work collectively to address the social and health inequities. And one last thing, as you enter into the nursing world and position yourselves as members of the healthcare team, never underestimate the power of kindness and always try to be kinder than necessary. Congratulations and welcome into the nursing profession. We're thrilled to have you.
Hello and welcome, everybody. I am so pleased you are having this virtual celebration, and thank you, Dr. Olszewski, for inviting me to say a few words. The pinning ceremony, even when virtual, is an important rite of passage, and I am honored to celebrate this critical moment in your journey to being a nurse, even if I am speaking to you through a screen. So first, a heartfelt congratulations and a round of applause to our almost 100 graduates. And what an extraordinary time to graduate. You are graduating during an unprecedented and historical moment in time defined by the COVID-19 pandemic and the extremely painful exposure of health inequities and the systemic, structural, and institutional racism experienced by individuals who are Asian, Black, African American, and of color, as well as how inequities are experienced with the intersection of gender, race, class identities. You are graduating in the midst of a global movement against social, criminal, and racial injustices that characterize our country, and healthcare is front and center to this movement. Not only does racism affect access to healthcare and service delivery, but it affects racism and lifelong exposures to discrimination, poor housing, poor education, actually make people sick and shortens their lifespan. By all of these accounts, you can see that our world desperately needs you and awaits your leadership, your attention to health inequities, your understanding of science, and your use of evidence-based practices. And I am so proud to know that you are already been contributing through volunteering your time to participate in testing or vaccination sites in our region. Being a nurse is one of the most versatile and important professions that one can pursue. As you may know, it is the most trusted health profession in every survey, in every country, and worldwide. As a nurse, you have a significant opportunity and a responsibility, and some would say an obligation, to positively impact the health and well-being of individuals, families, communities, and our society, and address inequities, particularly as it concerns discriminatory practices that permeate access to and delivery of evidence-based healthcare to individuals and their families. So I have been Dean of the College of Nursing and Health Professions for just over 3 years, and I can say with complete confidence that you have received an impressive and extremely rigorous education from inspiring, knowledgeable, dedicated, and passionate faculty and professional staff. We are proud to say that you are graduating from the largest college of Drexel University that provides the world with our next leaders and practitioners in healthcare. As graduates, you join our vast network of alumni or lifelong learners. The successes achieved by our graduates are incredibly inspiring, and I am confident that your careers will be too. Keep in mind that we are always here for you. Consider Drexel for life. As our new leaders in healthcare, I ask that you work hard to change our healthcare systems. And if you have any doubts about that possibility, I leave you with an African proverb that I learned from one of our PhD nursing students who graduated a few years ago. Quote, if you think you are too small to make a difference, then you haven't spent a night with a mosquito. So graduates, go change our healthcare world. And once again, I extend my heartfelt congratulations, and I look forward to learning of all of your career journeys as they in turn enrich us. Thank you.
My name is Uchenna Ekabu. I would like to stand on existing protocols, but I recognize the presence of the Dean of College of Nursing and Health Professions, the Chair, Nursing Accelerated Career Entry Program, Dr. O, distinguished faculty, distinguished members of the pinning committee, distinguished friends and families, my fellow graduates, all protocols observed. I feel honored and humbled to have been selected by faculty to present this speech on this great occasion of our pinning. The focus of my speech will be in line with its chosen theme, resilience, a proof that we have been tenacious, steady, resourceful, and flexible in the face of crisis, uncertainty, and threat. I have been asked to make it very brief, I guess because we are all healthcare workers and nurses now, and need to quickly get back to our patients. We were drawn to this amiable nursing profession due to our desire to make a positive impact on people, to show love, to care, to support, to be present, to advocate for our patients, and to show empathy amongst others. It has been an arduous journey filled with sweat, tears, doggedness, and resilience. When we made that choice to come to Drexel, not knowing that it would be this tough, we were sure that our ambitions can't wait. But there were three main attractions to this great institution. First, the ACE program was one of the shortest in the country, 11 months. Secondly, Drexel have consistently had an NCLEX pass rate of 97 to 100% over the years. The third reason was that Drexel had an innovative evidence-based curriculum taught by world-class faculty. These fantastic professors are behind our successful completion of this program, and hence this pinning. No sooner have we started this program in April 2020 than a global health issue of pandemic proportions hit the world and threatened our program, our lives, our families, healthcare workers, nurses, and our nation. We lost some of our loved ones, friends, and families. Let us observe a moment of silence in honor of those that passed away during this period and due to COVID-19. May their souls rest in peace. Amen. True to their resilience, Drexel management and faculty fashioned a way forward for us to continue the program. Their quick adaptation and investment in technology enabled us to have an online study intermingled with some real life and critical clinical experiences. Using their networks, Drexel took us to some great facilities for clinicals, even when some schools could not afford to get signed up for such. We say thank you. Our experience in this program has been heartwarming amidst the academic rigor and discipline that it entailed. To be successful, we have worked extra hard, managed our time effectively, denied ourselves sometimes, said goodbyes to some extracurricular activities, slept a little, and even cried. Many thanks to our families and friends for supporting us all the way. We never knew it would be so intense. We have been resilient because we cultivated the habit of not surrendering. We have been resilient because we had a never-say-never attitude. We believed, even when the concepts were not clear enough, that we will go back and study and better our understanding. In our resilience, some of us also made babies during this tough program. Congrats to them. True to our dragon spirit, we adapted to the new study format thrown at us and embraced it quickly, believing that we want to join the nursing force to combat the COVID-19 pandemic and other health issues in a year that the World Health Organization has termed the Year of Nurses and Midwives. Now we have joined that nursing force. We learned about thinking priority, thinking ABCs, thinking safety, and much more. A lot of quizzes and assignments and exams seemed to be on our necks all the time, but we managed to survive. When I complained to my spouse about the unending doses of academic work, she simply said, "But what do you expect when you applied, accepted, and signed up while beating your chest that you successfully complete a 4-year program in 11 months? Others have done it, and so can you." This pinning is a testament of our resilience and performance. Congratulations to the best Drexel ACE cohort ever, the Pandemic ACE Nurses. We all deserve the accolades. Congratulations. Our pinning marks the beginning of the real test of our mettle. The world beckons on us to quickly join hands to be change agents in any nursing field we find ourselves. We must show that we graduated from one of the best nursing schools in the United States. This must be done through our actions, our voice, our presence, our dedication to duty, and our resilience. Let us be beacons of light and hope to patients and their families. Let our voices and actions bring healing and joy to people. Let us be true nursing professionals and make positive contributions to healthcare. Please remember your ABCs, but always recall that our patients will never read our PowerPoints and may therefore present in manners that we do not expect. Using exceptional assessment and critical thinking skills will always be needed as we move forward. Let that dragon spirit be alive in us and never allow us to give up despite the odds. Let us remember to improve ourselves along the way. It is in so doing that we will renew and improve healthcare. It has been fast and furious, but we are here. Together, we believed. Together, we finished strong. Let's make a difference. To my friends, colleagues, and fellow graduates, hooray! Congratulations. To our families for the unflinching support. To my wife, Amara, thank you so much. To our professors, now our colleagues, our senior colleagues, thank you so much for your support and understanding. To God Almighty, glory and honor. Amen.
As a new graduate of the Drexel Bachelor of Science Nursing Program, we would like to present you with your Drexel Nursing Pin. Pinning signifies the transition from student nurse to professional nurse and your entry into the world of our nursing colleagues.
The nursing pin is a symbol of your new place in that world. It demonstrates in a visible way where you have come from, the Drexel University program, as well as where you are headed.
As you see others wearing their nursing school pins, know it is an outward sign that recognizes the hard work that women and men have done in order to become a nurse.
The nursing pin harkens back to the Middle Ages, when nobles were permitted to wear a symbolic coat of arms in recognition of loyalty and service to the king. Later, coats of arms were developed by craftsmen, guilds, and by universities.
Graduates of Florence Nightingale's School of Nursing were identified by a badge with the Maltese cross on their uniforms.
Over time, other nursing schools developed pins, reflecting important dimensions within nursing. The Drexel nursing pin is gold, surrounded by royal blue outline, representing our school's colors.
In the outline are the words Drexel Nursing, along with the Drexel dragon and the letters BSN. In the center of the pin is an open book, which reflects the scientific knowledge present within our profession.
Within the open book is a lamp, recalling the lamp carried by Florence Nightingale in the Crimean War. It represents nursing's legacy of constancy, caring, science, and informed patient advocacy.
Please accept this pin in
Hello, nurses. This is Professor Carroll. I want to give a huge congratulations to all of you. We are all so incredibly proud of this wonderfully special and brave group who started their program in March of 2020 and decided to keep that commitment despite the world shutting down. They started nursing school. All of you did the very next week. 2 weeks later, something like that. And now here you are a year later, graduating and going out into the world to become nurses. I just want to reiterate how much we admire all of you. Your strength, your dedication, your resilience is all so incredibly special. And I'm not sure I would have made the same choice that you did to persevere in those circumstances. So I'm really honored to share the nursing profession with people who are as brave as you. So now I'm going to read the Nurse's Pledge. I want you to all kind of keep this in your hearts as you go through your career. There are gonna be a lot of good days that you're gonna have as a nurse, a lot of highs, and there are also gonna be a lot of really challenging days and a lot of really low points. So I hope that you hold this Nurse's Pledge close to your heart and take it out when you really need to remember what nursing is all about. So here we go. Here's the nursing pledge. In full knowledge of the obligation that I am undertaking, I promise to care for individuals competently and compassionately, without regard to race, creed, color, and political or social status. I will continually strive to fulfill the profession's caring mission, to help individuals maintain or return to optimum states of health, or to assist them to die with dignity and peace. I will hold in confidence all personal information entrusted to me and will refrain from any action which may endanger the life or health of another. With commitment and integrity, I will endeavor to do all in my power to uphold and elevate the standard of my practice, to honor the nursing code of ethics, and to devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. That's the nurse's pledge. And I just want to reiterate how incredibly proud that all of us are to be sharing this profession with such brave people who have persevered through so many challenging situations this year. And I want to leave you with one final quote that I think Amanda Gorman really summed up how we feel about all of you best. She said, "The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it." And that's how I feel about all of you, that you're all brave enough to be it. So go out there and make us proud. I know you will.